Hello, my name is Wenping. Lately, I received several messages on LinkedIn, Twitter, or X. People are saying that they are new to bug bounty and try to hunt for several types of bugs, but to no avail. No, don't do that. If you are new to bug bounty, I would suggest you focus on just one type of bug for a start. Don't overwhelm yourself. Stay focused. Personally, I started off focusing on hunting for cross-site scripting bug. And I think you should also do the same if you are a bug bounty beginner. Cross-site scripting is a web security vulnerability which allows an attacker to perform arbitrary JavaScript execution on a user's web browser. In other words, depending on how the web application was being designed and developed, an attacker could potentially gain full control of the victim's user account. There are three reasons why I recommend bug bounty beginners to focus on cross-site scripting bugs. Reason number one, cross-site scripting is easier to learn as compared to other bugs because it is a client-side attack. When you attempt to inject a payload into a form or a parameter, you can observe the output that was being rendered on your web browser. With a bit of patience, you can fast it by submitting the form multiple times to observe the output and see if it will render any JavaScripts. As everything is processed on the client side, they are being rendered on your web browser, so you can better understand what is happening. After some time, you will become very familiar with identifying websites that are vulnerable to cross-site scripting bugs. Reason number two, cross-site scripting can be automated easily. There are many amazing tools out there, such as SSSTrike and DalFox, which can help in detecting potential cross-site scripting bugs automatically. Most tools also support pipe input and output for better chaining of commands with other tools. Of course, I would recommend that you learn how to find cross-site scripting bugs manually first, before automating them. Reason number three, cross-site scripting bugs are difficult to be disputed. If you can create a proof of concept and demonstrate the risk, do it. A cross-site scripting bug is at least a medium severity risk rating and can go up as high as critical. Based on my personal experience, if your cross-site scripting report has a working proof of concept, the chance of it being accepted is very high. In comparison, some other bugs might be arguable in terms of impact or whether they should be accepted as a bug in the first place, such as a business logic bug. In conclusion, the reason why I recommend bug bounty beginners to focus on the cross-site scripting bug is because 1. It is easier to learn as compared to other bugs. You can fuzz it manually and observe the output that was being rendered on your web browser. 2. It can be automated easily using popular tools and eventually integrate those tools into your bug hunting workflow. 3. It is difficult to be disputed, and its severity risk rating is at least a medium and could go up to critical depending on the impact which you are able to demonstrate. With this, I have come to the end of my tip sharing session. I hope the tips I have shared are useful to you, especially bug bounty beginners. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you have other bug bounty tips for bug bounty beginners as well, please add them in the comments. Have fun and keep hunting!